Jesteśmy w Kownie. Za mną budynek, w którym w 1940 roku znajdował się konsulat Cesarstwa Japonii. I tutaj możecie Państwo sobie wyobrazić, gdzie ja stoję na tej ulicy, aż do tej bramki. Tutaj wcześniej był mur, kłębił się tłum kilkuset polskich Żydów i nie tylko Żydów, obywateli Polski, uciekinierów z zachodu. Tutaj rozbijano namioty, ludzie stali i czekali na co? Na wizy życia. Ponieważ w tym budynku, zaraz wejdziemy do środka, urzędował konsul Cesarstwa Japonii, Sugihara, Chune Sugihara, który wystawiał wizy tranzytowe przez Japonię. Wizy, które jak się miało okazać, uratowały życie około 6 tysiącom polskich Żydów. Oni najpierw uzyskali wizy do Curacao i Surinami od konsula holenderskiego, ale żeby dostać się do tych kolonii Królestwa Niderlandów, musieli mieć wizę tranzytową przez Japonię. I Sugihara zgodził się i przez wiele dni, dniami i nocami, 24 godziny na dobę niemal wystawiał wizy tym polskim uciekinierom. Oni następnie przez Moskwę na Syberię przedostali się do Japonii i to uratowało im życie. W Japonii zaopiekował się nimi polski konsul Tadeusz Romer. Ci Żydzi polscy, którzy zostali na Litwie, zostali zgładzeni przez Niemców w trakcie Holokaustu. Także Sugihara, który tutaj działał w 1940 roku, kiedy była okupacja sowiecka oczywiście, uratował życie wielu, wielu ludziom. Dzisiaj ma status wielkiego bohatera w Japonii, również na Litwie. W budynku, w którym teraz jesteśmy, jak Państwo widzą, powiewa tutaj dumnie flaga Japonii obok flagi litewskiej. Ma on status absolutnego bohatera, chociaż po wojnie został potraktowany strasznie, bo wyrzucono go ze służby dyplomatycznej, ponieważ te wizy wystawiał wbrew wyraźnemu zakazowi swojego Ministerstwa Spraw Zagranicznych, które nie chciało sobie zadrażniać stosunków z sojusznikiem, z III Rzeszą, ale on uznał, że ratowanie ludziom życia jest ważniejsze niż lojalność wobec Tokio. Proponuję, żebyśmy zajrzeli do środka. Drodzy Państwo, to jest niesamowity dokument, kopia listy Sugihary. Setki, takich stron jest bardzo dużo, nazwisk polskich Żydów i Polaków, których Sugihara uratował. Jesteśmy w ogóle w niesamowitym miejscu, w środku willi w środku byłego konsulatu japońskiego. Japońska flaga, biurko, w tym miejscu Sugihara wystawiał wizy życia. A jest z nami i naszym gospodarzem dzisiaj jest pani Ewa Miczulite. Very nice, charming lady. That is a deputy director of the Sugihara Museum in Kaunas. Thank you very much for joining the show.
Well, thank you for visiting Kaunas.
Well, it's very impressive to be here inside the houses of Sugihara. But my first question would be, he was a Japanese diplomat, and what he was doing in Kaunas? Was there any Japanese community in Kaunas in 1940?
So, a very good question, and actually Sugihara's main reason for coming to Lithuania in general was to collect information about the changing border, both with the Soviet Union as well as with the Nazi Germany. There were no Japanese community in Kaunas or in Lithuania whatsoever, and for him, Lithuania at that time was the perfect location to gather this information.
So, you can say that he was a spy.
Yes, we could say that he was a spy, but at the same time during the interwar period, 1939, 1940, well, the late interwar period, the majority of diplomats were collecting information for their countries. If they were not, then they were probably not such well and good diplomats, I guess.
Yeah, sure. And he came here by himself or with his family or compatriots?
He actually came to Lithuania with his family, so he came together with his second wife, Yukiko Sugihara, two children, Hiroki and Chiaki, while residing in Lithuania, the third child of the Sugihara family. Oh yeah, I can show it to you. So this is Hiroki, Chiaki, and then Haruki Sugihara right in the middle, who was born in Kona City in 1948.
Yes, and unfortunately this young boy died very early. In 1947, after the war, something like that.
Yes, after the family returned back to Japan. And also the younger sister of Sugihara's wife, Setsuko Kikuchi, also came to Lithuania to help look mm-hmm. after the children.
Okay, so right now the Polish connection.
Yes.
All the Polish viewers are waiting for this. So what happened? Right now, I read some books about that, and Sugihara wrote that one day came and he looked outside from this window, and the people were just standing mm-hmm. here and waiting. Who were those people and what they were waiting for?
Mm-hmm. So the Sugihara looked from the second floor window because originally this house was surrounded by a fence, so the people were waiting on the street. He saw a majority of the people who were Jewish refugees, and they wanted to get basically any visa, preferably a proper visa, but even a transit visa to Japan would help them. The majority of them were Polish residents who came to Lithuania through the occupied for the Soviet-occupied Polish territory. Mm-hmm. And it was even easier for them to come to Lithuania after Vilnius was given back to Lithuania by the Soviet government. So roughly speaking, the majority of them, 95%, as we can see from the list, were Polish Jews.
Mm-hmm. And I understand that they were the transfer visa.
Yes.
Because they were going to Netherlands colonies like Curacao and Suriname. What happened with those people? Let's say I'm a Polish Jew, I came here to this apartment, I pick up my visa,
yes.
And what then?
So if you were lucky enough, first of all, to receive Sugihara's visas, because unfortunately Sugihara could not issue out visas for a very long time since he was, he had to move later on to Germany and to leave Lithuania as it was occupied by the Soviet Union, and diplomatic offices were closed one by one. So if you were lucky enough to get Sugihara visa, you would then go to Jan Zwanzadijk, who was the honorary consul of the Netherlands working in Kaunas, to get a visa to Curacao or Suriname colonies in the Caribbean. But this visa, basically the Suriname and Curacao visas, they were more for show than for using. The Polish refugees the Jewish refugees that came for Sugihara to get the transit visa, they were lucky enough to leave Lithuania, because the journey from Kaunas to, well, Tsuruga, Japan, it was very expensive, and they were refugees. They got some money support from joining the Jewish organization. Mm-hmm. However, not everybody had the financial means to use it.
Okay, but let's speak about the geography of this saving cooperation. They were going through Moscow and then through Trans-Siberian Railway?
Yes. So we actually have a map of the Trans-Siberia Railway right here. So from Kaunas, then they would later on go to Moscow and then through the Trans-Siberia Railway to Vladivostok. This journey took roughly 2 weeks, a little bit less than 2 weeks. And if you can imagine how comfortable the trains are right now, they were not so at all in the 1940s.
Especially in the Soviet Union.
Especially in Siberia, which has the tendency not only to be bloody cold in winter, but horribly humid in summer. A lot of the refugees, by the time they reach Vladivostok, they had some rash, they had a cough because of the unbearable conditions, and they were even, many of them were afraid that they would not be let into Japan because, tuberculosis was a prevailing illness at the time, and you being with a rash and coughing is already something to be concerned of.
Yes, and then, as we spoke before we put our cameras on, they were helped by the Polish ambassador in Tokyo, Mr. Tadeusz Romer.
Yes.
And this is mind-blowing information that the one guy, Mr. Sugihara, who was sitting here in this room when we speak right now, saved 6,000 people. That's really amazing. What a hero. But my last question is, this is not a well-known thing, that he was actually cooperating here in Kaunas with the Polish intelligence, with the Polish underground. Tell us something about that.
Well, Sugihara had a couple of assistants, so aside from Mr. Wolfgang Gutsche, who was a German residing in Lithuania, his other assistants were Polish, so Jan Stanislav Daszkiewicz and Jerzy Kuncewicz. I apologize for butchering their names, as well as his driver was Mr. Bolesław Roszycki. They helped Sugihara a lot, not only with the visa issuing process, but also most likely with gathering information and so on. Of course, if Sugihara had left us all of the notes stating how exactly he cooperated with the Polish underground, then he would have not been a good, well, intelligence officer. So he did not leave this information, but we can see that his chauffeur, Mr. Bolesław Roszycki, had documents issued out which allowed him to travel freely, basically to help Sugihara with his errands. And Sugihara is also basically remembered by his wife, would also quite often stray from his family to the trips when they went to the Lithuanian border. And his assistants are both well known in the Polish underground. So some people might think it is a coincidence. However, Sugihara Tune himself is a very calculated man. As the stories tell us, what the refugees themselves still remember, and what we can pick from the documentations, he was really cooperating a lot with the Polish intelligence, underground intelligence at that time, as well as the Polish intelligence at that time everywhere in Europe was actually quite advanced and actually very impressively advanced. Mm.
I'm sure that the Polish people, the Polish viewers will love it, what you just said, but what a story. A Polish-Japanese-Dutch cooperation to save the Jews. And it's the happy end story.
Yes.
And that's the most important part of it. Thank you very much for interview. Thank you very much for having us here in this beautiful museum of yours. And dear viewers of Historia Realna, drodzy państwo, come to Kaunas, come to see this place. Thank you very much once again.
Thank you so much for coming.
No jak Państwo widzą, rzeczywiście jest to niesamowite miejsce. Jeżeli japońskie wycieczki przyjeżdżają do tej części Europy, to możecie być Państwo pewni, że przyjadą tutaj do Kowna zobaczyć miejsce, w którym Sugihara wystawiał wizy życia. Jest to na pewno bardzo ważne miejsce również dla Polaków, również zachęcam Państwa, jeżeli jesteście na Litwie, żebyście tutaj przyjechali, ponieważ ludzi, których ratował Sugihara, to byli polscy obywatele, obywatele II Rzeczypospolitej, głównie polscy Żydzi, ale oczywiście nie tylko. Niestety, drodzy Państwo, jest wielki paradoks. Sugihara, tak jak mówiłem na początku, ma status bohatera narodowego w Japonii, gdzie został całkowicie zrehabilitowany. Ma status bohatera tutaj na Litwie. Na całym świecie, między innymi w Stanach Zjednoczonych, są ulice Sugihary, place Sugihary, pomniki Sugihary. Kręci się o nim filmy, są przedstawienia teatralne, filmy dokumentalne. Ale co ciekawe, nie został upamiętniony w godny sposób w Polsce. Wyobraźcie sobie państwo, że ten dzielny japoński dyplomata, który ratował tutaj, no właśnie, obywateli Polski, nie ma w Polsce ani jednej ulicy, ani jednego placu, jest postacią właściwie w ogóle nieznaną, co jest paradoksalne, mimo że był dobroczyńcą naszych rodaków. W związku z tym teraz tutaj w Kownie, w tym miejscu, w imieniu swoim, w imieniu całej ekipy Historii Realnej, w imieniu wszystkich, jak domyślam się, również państwa, mam nadzieję, zwracam się do władz państwowych Rzeczypospolitej Polskiej. Naprawcie ten błąd. Sugihara zasługuje na ulicę w reprezentacyjnym miejscu w Warszawie. Drodzy państwo, na koniec tradycyjny apel do naszych widzów. Wspierajcie Historię Realną. Subskrybujcie kanał, lajkujcie filmy, komentujcie filmy, wspierajcie nas na Patronite, wspierajcie nas na YouTubie. Dziękuję przy okazji za wsparcie panu Pawłowi Osowskiemu, dzięki któremu ten wyjazd był możliwy. Paweł Osowski jest jednym z naszych patronów, a więc wsparcie przynosi bardzo konkretne efekty. Piotr Zychowicz, Historia Realna, Kowno.